श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। ओम सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। ओम पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराण मुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्बत्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवद्गीते भवद्वेषिणीं यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरा सुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः देवाय तस्मै नमः। वेंकटरामन महोदय சித்தப்பா அன்மியூட் பண்ணிக்கிறேல ஓகே வில் சாண்ட் ஃப்ரம் நம்பர் 27 பிரகிருதே கிரியமானானி
கிரியமானானி
குண இருக்கா அரிய
குணை கர்மாணி சர்வசஹ
குணை கர்மாணி சர்வசஹ
கர்மாணி சர்வசஹ
அஹங்கார விமூடாத்மா
அஹங்கார விமூடாத்மா
கர்த்தாஹமிதி மன்யதே
கர்த்தாஹமிதி மன்யதே
தத்வவித்து மகாபாஹோ
தத்வவித்து மகாபாஹோ
குணகர்ம விபாகயோ
குணகர்ம விபாகயோ
குணேஷு வர்த்தந்தே
குணா குணேஷு வர்த்தந்தே तन्ते
इति मत्वा न सज्जते
इति मत्वा न सज्जते
प्रकृतेर्गुणसम्मूढाः
प्रकृते गुणसम्मूढाः
सज्जन्ते गुणकर्मसु
सज्जन्ते गुणकर्मसु
तान कृत्स्न विदो मंदान
दान कृष्ण विदो मंदान
कृत्स्न विन्न विचालयेत
कृष्ण विन्न विशालयेत
मयि सर्वाणि कर्माणि
मयि सर्वाणि कर्माणि
संन्यस्याध्यात्म चेतसा
संन्यस्याध्यात्मचेतसा
निराशीर्निर्ममो भूत्वा
निराची निर्ममो भूत्वा
युध्यस्व विगत ज्वरः
युध्यस्य विगत ज्वरः
ये मे मतमिदं नित्यम्
ये मे मतमिदं नित्यम्
अनुतिष्ठन्ति मानवाः
अनुतिष्ठन्ति मानवाः
श्रद्धावन्तो न सूयन्तः
श्रद्धावन्तो न सूयन्तः
मुच्यन्ते तेऽपि कर्मभिः
मुच्यन्ते तेऽपि कर्मभिः
So this is the shloka 31 which we were studying last time. Yeme matamidam nityam anutishthanti manavah. So he's referring to this teaching that I have been talking about so far. Me matam anutishthanti manavah. Those people who follow this teaching always nityam. And then two more words are being used to describe them. Okay, the first word there is first word in the second line, shraddhavantaha. So he brings the word shraddha here. So we studied shraddha when we discussed what is called adhikaritva. So those of you who have joined classes recently, so it helps to catch up on the past classes, because there is some important background information that we have covered. And what is required for a person to pursue this shastra? So vivekam, vairagyam, we saw all that. So discernment, ability to discern between atma and anatma. And then vairagyam, dispassion. So being dispassionate about anatma, so clarity about what anatma and anatma is, from which you get what is called vairagyam. Then shatka sampatti, shamadi, shamadama, we discussed that. So there you have shraddha, sixfold qualifications, there you have shraddha. And then last one, mamukshutva. And so that shraddha, We said Shraddha is Shrat Dadati Iti Shraddha. Shrat means knowledge. That which gives knowledge is called Shraddha. That's a literal meaning. Look at that. Look at these Sanskrit words, how they are. They try to tell you the meaning even before you look up the dictionary. So, a belief pending verification. This is how Swamiji had defined Shraddha. So therefore, it's not blind belief, because pending verification, you are supposed to verify it yourself. How do I know I'm going to get all this stuff that Krishna is going to talk about? What is the guarantee? You know, what's the guarantee? They give you, you know, guarantee, warranty with everything. 1 year warranty if you buy these things, you know, washing machine, 1 year guarantee. Then for the motor, some 5 years guarantee. Like this, they give you all that. And then, by the way, if you pay a little more, you can double the warranty period to 2 years, you know, all that they give. Now, can we do something to Krishna so he can increase our warranty period, you know? Such thing is not possible, not needed also, because pending verification, I can verify whether I got moksha or not. Why? How do you know that? Because it's knowledge. Knowledge is, that's the power of knowledge. power of knowledge. And so Krishna will tell later also, Shraddhavan Labhate Jnanam. In the fourth chapter, he will say that. The one who has Shraddha gains knowledge. So why the Shraddha is needed? Shraddha is needed in many things we do. You know, we send our school to children, young, you know, hardly walking, and that school, that baby has got to go to school. And it's a big traumatic event for the child. And the parents are very anxious. Come on, come on, go to school. There's so much for you to study, you know. I want you to be successful in life. Start, go to school. And this child is crying and he doesn't want to go to school. But Shraddha, Shraddha is there. The parents know very well that when the child goes here, she will be. Well, that is the best place for her. There's no doubt about that. And regardless of the type of teachers, there can be surprises. You know, the school is not good and this, that, and violence, all these things are there. So, Shraddha, it's because what we think may not actually pan out, may not actually be. The reality may be different than what we think. All those are possible there. But here, not possible. Because this is not a trip to heaven. And so you can say, oh, great, finally, Krishna has answered my prayers, you know. That also you can't say, because verification has to be done right now, when I'm alive in this life, not in the next life. That verification is not possible. And so therefore, that Shraddha is there. And why Shraddha is needed is because several reasons we can give. First reason is that what Krishna is telling is contradictory to my experience. Correct? It's contradictory. You know, I am a mortal, if you say. That's believable. I know I'm a mortal and you're telling me I'm a mortal. There's nothing to dispute that. But here Krishna is saying you are immortal. There is a problem. There is a serious problem with this statement. And what is immortal? The body is going to perish and you are full, you are complete. This doesn't ring true at all, correct? Because I am small, whichever way I look at it. I may be the greatest, you know, I may be the president of America. Look at him now. So how sad it is, the situation. So, you know, they're trying to impeach him. And so, wherever you are, whichever position I take, I am limited. Correct? Very limited. And so, this one, Shastram is saying, you are Avinashi. Okay? And I am imperishable. So, whenever we understand something, something is told to us to understand. Our understanding is based on what we already know. We know something now. Now tell me something that I can understand. That is the way our knowledge keeps growing, correct? So that's how child goes, first grade, second grade, third grade. Then there is addition is being taught. And once addition is taught, the teacher will not jump to division. Division is, it takes a little more time. Let's learn subtraction. Let's learn multiplication. Then let's talk about division. So there is a progression there. Because that's how it works. That's how the knowledge is. Keep slowly. Based on my knowledge of addition, I can understand subtraction. Then based on that, I can go further. I can go further. I can go further. This is how it is. But here, from I am being mortal to I am immortal. What is this? Is this something we can even begin to understand? And so it's not just mind-boggling. Swamiji says it's not mind-boggling. It is very silly. Very silly. Somebody comes to you and says, you are a trillionaire. You're a trillionaire. Doesn't matter any currency, dollar currency, rupee currency, it doesn't matter. That's why I chose a big number, trillionaire. What? You're not a billionaire. You're a trillionaire. And you ignore the fellow. Something is wrong. Come on, let's talk about the weather. Let's talk about something else, right? So that must be the thing. No, no, no. Then he has lunch with you. And then he says, you are a trillionaire. Come on, what's going on? You know, do you need to go to the hospital or something? I know some good doctors, okay? I can help you with that. So that'll be the thing. And so it's very silly. Somebody comes and tells me I'm a trillionaire. So if I'm a trillionaire, why should I worry about all these power cuts and all these things, you know? So it's a meaningless statement. So Shastra, what it says, appears meaningless. That is why. But it is not meaningless. This is the in thing. This is it. And so how do I go from being mortal to being immortal? Then we have also already seen, thankfully, I'm not going to make my body immortal. The body is mortal, no doubt. Body, you can't change. And the Atma is immortal. Avinashi, Nityam, all these things we have seen. And so to go from here to there, Shraddha is needed. I must believe that what the Shastram says is true. What Krishna is saying is true. And yesterday when we were studying Bhagavad Gita, Shankara Bhashyam, and in one place, Shankara is doing this debate between the Purva Pakshi and Siddhanta. So Shankara will create questions. And in there, Shankara is covering all bases. And he introduces a statement that Purva Pakshi says, you know what? Arjuna really did not understand. That's why he's asking this question. Okay, that's the Purva Pakshi. Then Siddhanti. And then Shankara proves that no, Arjuna did understand. He understood. Then Purva Pakshi, Shankara introduces, oh, Krishna is confused. You know, Purva Pakshi is saying, no, Krishna is confused. He doesn't know what he's talking about. And then Shankara comes back and says, why Krishna is not confused? So very interesting the way you look at all this. So we can't take that route. It's not available to us that, you know, we can begin to doubt all of our rishis and Vedas and all that. That option is not available to us. It's not needed. Not needed. So this mithya, satyam and mithya, we talked about that. And that's critical in understanding this. Satyam and mithya. And everything is real to me. And Shastram says, yeah, there is a certain reality to everything, but that is not absolutely real. That not absolutely real is mithya, and absolutely real is satyam. And so the wave is mithya, water is satyam. The pot is mithya, clay is satyam. Because even after the pot is gone, the clay remains. And what remains is satyam. And that satyam you are, mrityaketyeva satyam. Like that, the father Uddhalaka tells Svetaketu. Okay, so that mithyatvam has to be recognized. And so it's an important, very important topic. And, you know, we have to spend time mulling over this. And otherwise, we get into things like world is an illusion. World is an illusion. So somebody tells world is an illusion. This is what I suggest you do. You just slap him. Just give him one, you know. And then let's see the response. Let's see the response. And if he's furious, you say, the world is an illusion. I really did not slap you. Let's see his response further. If he was angry before, now he's going to be furious. World is an illusion. World is a delusion. This, that. You see all kinds of words in the books. Huh? How can they say all these things? World is not illusion. World is mithya. Mithya is not illusion. Mithya is not delusion. Mithya is not... You know, mithya is important. We have to respect mithya. Mithya is vyavaharika satyam. So we talked about three types of satyam. I'm not going to repeat all that here. Okay. So in Buddhism, that mithya becomes satyam. And even that satyam is taken away and says, I am void. I am shunyaha. So different form, different types of discussions are there. So understanding what the satyam and mithya is crucial, and shraddha is needed. Shraddha is needed all the way until that knowledge takes place. And so shraddha, what is the definition of shraddha is guru vedanta vakyeshu vishwasaha shraddha. The words, I consider the words of my teacher and the shastram to be true. That is how in Tattva Bodha he defines that word shraddha. Okay, some of you can recall that. Okay, now second reason for shraddha, sometimes we have the feeling that we've studied shastram so much, and many people, they get empowered when we study the shastram, and because it just provides so many, just gives food for thought, and suddenly it opens a whole new world. And but sometimes we say, I've been studying for so long, nothing has happened to me, why am I like this? Correct? Why is my life like this? How come things are not improving? This feeling can be there. Correct? Feeling can be there. No tangible result. You go to the store and buy something, immediate tangible result. You go to anything you do, profession, tangible result is there. And everywhere there is a result that you, there is a tangible result. Even the child going to school comes back after a year, tangible result. And the child is constantly learning. But here, what is happening, what should happen, not clear. So sometimes we have that feeling that, there is, punyam is there, papam is there, antakarana shuddhi is there. This is antakarana shuddhi is supposed to be a tangible result. And I feel I now have a say over my ways of speaking, my ways of thinking. And raga dveshas, yes, I appreciate the importance of that. This is all you can say. Nothing will come. The courier service is not going to knock on your door and give you a package. Not going to come, right? So that's another reason we have to keep the shraddha. We have to shastram keeps saying that shraddha is important. And thirdly, maybe a wrong usage. I don't think it's right. Shastram is a pramanam. Pramanam. So we talked about the importance of pramanam. Pramanam, like the eyes, like the ears. The ears reveal something. The eyes reveal something. Eyes have the capability of revealing forms and colors. Okay. And for that to happen, I have to operate my eyes. I have to operate my ears. Only if I operate the pramana works. How do you know the pramana works? Well, you have to operate it and see if it works. That is why the doctor keeps on asking you. You go to the eye doctor. A doctor keeps asking you, is this better or this better? Is this better or this better? That better or this better? Then after a while you have to ask, which compared to which? Then you have to say, no, that was better. That means which that was better, And it becomes an argument after that. And then you get confused. No, that was better. Wait a minute, I think that was better. That means the doctor has to decide what that is. And then he changes some more a few things. That is better. No, I thought the previous one was better. So finally, the doctor is relying on me entirely. I thought he has to tell me what are the right glasses, but I have to tell him what are the right glasses. What is this? This is pramanam. This is pramanam, correct? Pramanam means you operate it, you figure it out. You have to figure it out. Nobody in the world can figure it out for you. Even the eye doctor cannot figure it out for you. He can facilitate. He has a system. And Swamiji gives this joke. He says, hey, those days in Mumbai, there used to be people on the street. You know, those days, maybe go back. And they used to have all these glasses and frames. Okay? Because used frames, used glasses are all there. And why put it to waste? And then he used to ask me all these things. And sir, this ATK, OTK and all that. And then you put this, and then you put this frame and that frame and this frame and everything. And finally, something works. And that is how those days, 50 years ago, it was. And today I go to New York and I thought I'm going to find something great. And I went and saw this ophthalmologist. This man is doing exactly the same thing. That Mumbai wala, the street fellow, whatever he did, this fellow also is doing the same thing. And he's charging me so much money also. No difference at all. No difference. Why no difference? Pramanam. Pramanam means that's the way it will be. And so the pramanam has to be operated, and here shastram has to be operated. We are operating a pramanam. Even though we say we are studying the shastram, we are actually operating a pramanam. That pramanam has to tell me who I am. The pramanam can only do what it can do. Okay, think about it. The eyes, when you look at something here, and inside the home I'm sitting here, and when I open the eyes, I can't see a mountain. The pramanam cannot show me something that doesn't exist. Okay, that it can't show me something, it cannot create something new. Okay, and therefore the shastram also similar, same thing. It can only tell me who I am, and the shastram says there is nothing lacking. Atma is complete. Atma is purna. Atma is ananda swarupa. It is the responsibility of the shastram to tell me that. Correct? And it can't tell anything less. It can't tell anything more. And that is because the shastram is a pramanam. And so since I'm operating a pramanam, and the pramanam is self-proving. Okay? Self-proving means what? I have to operate it, and then it proves itself. And I can say, yes, it works, or it doesn't work. Only I can say that. And so, therefore, I accept the Vedas as pramanam. Okay? Look at this. Pramanam is important. How many teachers talk about pramanam? Swamiji was one of the first teachers to bring up this topic and say, this is so important. And pramanam is... Shastram is a pramanam. Otherwise, what will happen? It will become an academic study. Correct? Academic study. I didn't know what this academic study idea was until I met a person who knows so much about Vedanta. He keeps quoting verses and shlokas and shlokas. And I tried to talk to him, and he does not understand pramanam. He does not understand what moksha is. And he's quoting so much. He's a professor. Then I realized what Swamiji said. This is academic. It becomes academic. Academic means you can say all these things. You can study. You can even teach. But this, what is all this about? What does it do to me? Am I going to get a degree from all this? Am I going to get a certificate? And so that idea must be very clear here. And so... That is why Shraddha is needed. And neither can you prove. Neither can I come here and prove I am not Brahma. At least that much I must have. If Shastra is not true, then tell me what is true. You have to tell me something. And neither this nor that. Okay. So that also is not possible. And so therefore, that Shraddha enables me to say in this journey, it enables me to say the shastram is correct. And my understanding, I need to understand some more. I need to learn some more. And I'm getting there. I can see it happening. And I allow that journey to happen. And Shraddha makes that happen. Okay. And so Krishna had that attitude, clearly. Otherwise, And that is why in the beginning of the third chapter, he started a question. Mohayasi ivame vyamishreneva vakyena mohayasi buddhim mohayasi ivame. with words that are seemingly confusing. I feel as though I'm being confused by your words. As though. So he's using that clause, as though. So you're not confusing me, really. I know I didn't understand. That is his statement. And so Krishna cannot confuse. And so Arjuna recognizes that because he has that Shraddha. Okay. Now, that is, so Shraddhavantaha. What is the word Shraddhavantaha? What is the meaning? One who has Shraddha. People who have Shraddha are called Shraddhavantaha. So it would be an adjective to Manavaha. Right? In the shloka there, you have Manavaha. Na anutishthanti Manavaha. Correct? Manavaha. People. And who are they? They are Shraddhavantaha. They are people who have Shraddha in the Shastram. Guru, Vedanta Vakyeshu, Vishwasaha, Shraddha. And then they are also Anasuyantaha. Anasuyantaha. So same, Bhagavan, Bhagavantau, Bhagavantaha, Sanskrit class students. So Bhagavantaha means gods. And so plural of Bhagavan. And so same thing here, Shraddhavan, Shraddhavantaha. Then Anasuyantaha. Very interesting word the Krishna brings here. So girls, women are called Anasuya. Right? Have you heard of the name Anasuya? Yeah, Anasuya, all of us have heard. So especially in the south, I think it may be popular. I don't know in the north, Anasuya is there or not. Must be there, yeah. Few hands I can see. So here, two words to be understood. Matsaryaha and Asuyaha. Matsaryaha. Jealousy. Jealousy. What is jealousy? Somebody is doing good. Got a good job and they're going places, everything. And then I don't like it. I don't like it. That is called jealousy, right? Somebody is prosperous. I don't like it. The neighbor is doing well. Neighbor's children are studying better than my children. I don't like it. I'm jealous of my neighbor. I'm jealous of my neighbor's children. Correct? Jealousy. So, in Sanskrit, the definition is this. Para utkrishtam drishtva jayamana santapaha. Para utkrishtam drishtva. Para means another. Utkrishtam, prosperity, happiness. Somebody else is happy, I cannot stand it. Okay. Hey, what's your problem? You are not happy, that's your karma. Okay. So, let others be happy. No. How can others be happy? So, para utkrishtam drishtva, seeing the joy of other people, jayamana santapaha. Tapaha means some unpleasantness, some sadness. Santapaha, agony, right? You know, that's, look at the words. Don't you love Sanskrit? Jayamana santapaha. So, I am agonized because I see that fellow is doing really well. Okay, this is called jealousy. Okay, Matsaryaha. That's called Matsaryaha in Sanskrit. Now, the other word is Asuyaha. Asuya. And Asuya means going a little further. And finding defects in the other people. A neighbor's children are studying well. Yeah, I heard they always copy, you know, exams. Okay, this is called Asuya. It's called Asuya. Finding a fault where it doesn't exist. Finding a fault where it doesn't exist. And, that Swamiji is teaching very well. Yeah, you don't know enough about him. Okay. You know, that means what? I mean, I know so many things about that person. And if you knew all that, you would not be studying under that Swamiji. Okay. This is called Asuya. Asuya. So trying to find something, some skeletons in the closet that doesn't exist. Keep pulling out something, some defect, this and that, constantly criticizing. And so we see all that. And so Swami used to say, jealousy has to be nipped in the bud. If you don't nip it in the bud, nipping in the bud means what? You have to recognize this feeling. Anybody, any of us can have this feeling. and because the insecurity is there and anything is possible, and you nip it in the bud. Means you tell yourself, no, I will not allow myself to be a to encourage this kind of an emotion. I will be happy. Let everybody be happy. Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha. When I say sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, how can I be jealous of somebody else? Not possible. So I have to tell myself and just neutralize this thought completely. Nip it in the bud. Otherwise, it will just consume the human being. Engulf the human being will be lost. And so, very important. And so, so asuya. So why is Krishna has to say that? So the Bhagavad Gita and Karma Yoga. Okay, so Karma Yoga, Krishna is talking about. So tell me, are you a Karma Yogi? Are all these people Karma Yogis? Everybody, they are also suffering like me. What is the big difference? You study Bhagavad Gita, you became a Karma Yogi, and then you suffer. I am not a Karma Yogi, I also suffer. What is the difference? We don't need to study Bhagavad Gita to suffer, okay? And so, this is the argument. And so, like this, people can argue. And what is the use of studying? You are a young man. You shouldn't be studying Bhagavad Gita right now. Because that fellow also wants to study. But for some reason or the other, he doesn't have time or whatever. Instead of saying, appreciating all that, you know, Asuya is there. And you should not be studying all this, this and that. So all this unnecessary. And so therefore, Krishna is saying, people who do not find fault in this me matam, and such people alone, what? Look at that. Muchyante. Tepi karma bihi muchyante. Muchyante tepi karma bihi. Muchyante means what? Much, moksha. Same dhatu, same root. Much. Muchyante. They are freed. They're freed from what? Karma bihi. They're freed from karma. Two ways of looking at that. Karma bihi. So from kartritvam they are freed. They're no longer a karta. They recognize they're no longer a karta. Therefore, there is no such thing as action and result that belongs to them. So no result can attach to them. Actions are done, results are there, but no result is attached. They are not dependent. They are freed from being dependent on karma and karma phala. And of course, all the papa and punya that is there in my account, in the person's account, is all gone. So, muchyante karma bihi. And here we must make a note. We already learnt that karma is finite. And therefore, the result of karma is finite. And moksha being not in the realm of finiteness, moksha being whole, infinite, no karma or no series of actions, however long I do, can result in moksha. Okay, we saw that moksha is not a result of karma. Okay, therefore, here when Krishna says that muchyante karma bihi, which means by actions, antakarana shuddhi, and by antakarana shuddhi, jnanam, and jnanena mokshaha muchyante, that we must recall. Okay, so now let's go back to the shloka. Ye me matamidam nityam anutishthanti manavaha श्रद्धावंतो न सूयंता मुच्यन्ते तेपि कर्मभिः. Okay, those people who constantly follow this teaching of mine, ये मे मतम और इदम मतम नित्यम अनुतिष्ठन्ति मानवाः. ये मानवाः मे idam matam anutishthanti nityam. Okay, next, comma, full of shraddha, shraddhavantaha. Okay, comma, without finding fault with the teaching or the teacher. Look at that. Without finding fault means what? It doesn't mean one should not ask questions. It means don't attitude. It talks about the attitude here. Okay. So without finding fault with the teaching or the teacher. So that is the translation of anasuya, comma. They too are freed from the hold of karma phalas. They too are freed from the hold of karma phalas. Means they gain moksha. What they too means what? What is they too? Why should he say api? Api means too also. That is because of what we said. Jnanena moksha. By knowledge, one gets moksha. But here, the people who follow karma yoga also get moksha. Because karma yoga means karma is involved. It's an attitude. Karma cannot give moksha. But he, therefore, he says they too. Because that attitude is so important that they too get moksha. That is how it is to be interpreted. Okay. Now let's look at the next shloka, number 32. Okay. Anybody who has not had a chance to? Okay. Yeah, Balaji, go ahead.
अभ्यसूयन्तः
नानुतिष्ठन्ति
मे मतं
सर्वज्ञानविमूढान्
तान्
विद्धि नष्टान
अचेतसः
ये त्वे तदभ्यसूयन्तः नानुतिष्ठन्ति मे मतं सर्वज्ञानविमूढांस्तान्
सर्वज्ञानविमूढांस्तान्
विद्धि नष्टान चेतसः या सो नाउ कृष्णा इज कंट्रास्टिंग द पर्सन डिस्क्राइब्ड अर्लियर So the Shraddhavantaha, Anasuyavantaha, to the people who do not enjoy those attributes. So people who do not have Shraddha, people who are fault finders. Fault finders means proofreaders, right? Proofreading, we talked about that some time ago, I think. So the proofreader's job, unfortunately, is to find fault, okay? Hopefully, after he or she leaves office, it doesn't continue, right? He has to turn around. He says, you know what? I have to change my attitude. It's dangerous. This job is dangerous. I need to be careful. Otherwise, you talk to somebody and they say, where is downtown, whatever. And then he says, go there. No, you made a mistake in your sentence. There's a grammatical error, you know. No, you don't want to say all that. Just enjoy life, right? So he is now contrasting Krishna. And he's talking about those who are critical about everything, critical about the Shruti, etc. So here, two. So you can see now, ye, let me separate this. Ye, tu, next word is tu, and then etad. Etad means this. Then abhyasuyantaha. So I forgot to mention last time. So anasuyantaha. So asuya means that fault finding, you know, attitude. Asuya. Anasuya, of course, is one that does not have that. And so the an, you know, negates that attitude. So here, abhyasuyantaha, and then na anutishtanti me matam. Okay. Then sarvajnana vimudhan is the next word. And then tan vidhi, then nashtan and achetasaha. So tu ye tu, on the other hand, those who are abhyasuyantaha. So it doesn't mean Krishna is just dividing the world into two halves. You know, these are all people who are anasuyantaha, and they don't find fault, and here are the rest of the world who find fault. Not like that. It is advice to Krishna. Krishna, you be careful. Krishna is advising Arjuna. And Arjuna is saying, Krishna is telling Arjuna the importance of that Shraddha, and importance of giving that benefit of doubt to the Shastram. And if you don't, then you are the loser. Arjuna, you are the loser. And so, he's just cautioning. So, the Ninda and Stuti. Stuti, Ninda. Praise and Ninda. What is it? Ninda, how do you translate that? Not getting the word in English for that. But yeah, praise and the opposite of praise, you know. So that is what is being done here. Okay. So that means what? If you have knowledge, you're free. Otherwise, you will be in samsara. You will be constantly bound. And that is how life will be. So, telisite mokshamu teliyakunna bandhamu. So, our classical music songs, if you are all into classical music, it's great because Vedanta is there. Every song just flows with these kinds of messages. So, telisite, that's a Telugu song. So, probably Tyagaraja has written it. Telisite mokshamu means what? If you know, you got moksha. Teliyakunna bandhamu. If you don't know it, then you're bound. That's the song. Telisite mokshamu teliyakunna bandhamu. Like that it goes. Okay. So, then they na anutishthanti. These people, they don't follow. Na anutishthanti. Me matam. Me matam. They don't follow what? Me matam. My vision, my teaching, they don't follow. Na anutishthanti. So it's hard to follow. It's hard to follow disciplines. You know, getting up in the morning. It's not an easy thing. Some people it is very easy. I used to wonder how people get up at 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock and all that. And it's not possible. And so it's easy to just snooze. And so this guy gets up at 6 o'clock in the morning. This is great. And then he has coffee. And then he decides. Next thing he's deciding, should I go to sleep now? Or should I do something else? Hey, you had coffee. You got up, you brushed your teeth, you had coffee. I thought this day started. No. I'm deciding whether I need to sleep some more. Okay. So you ask this guy, when is sunrise? And he says, sunrise is when I get up. Okay, that is sunrise. That's his definition of sunrise. Okay. So life's good, you know. LG, life is good. And so difficult. LG, I think that word LG, these LG were smart people. Their advertisement, I think they say life's good, if I'm not mistaken. Otherwise, I wouldn't have got life's good. But then that word LG stands for something else. And then some lucky and gold star or something, correct? And two companies that started in 1940s or 50s, Lucky, this South Korean company, Lakhui, I think it is, L-A-K-H-U-I, Lakhui, some chemical company. And then Gold Star is another company, some plastics company, etc. And then, so Lucky and Gold Star combined together, and then they became LG. And so, that is some history that comes to my mind. So, like this, getting up in the morning, difficult. And now the time, you know what, this month is called Margashirsha in Sanskrit. Mrigashirsha. Margai in Tamil. Okay. Hindi maybe also they say Marga. Margashira, something like that. Margashirsha in Hindi. So during this time, what they will do is that you are supposed to get up at 4 in the morning and then, you know, finish off and then go to the temple. Go to the temple. Immediately, the people go to the temple. And then, you know, do the prayers there. Worship Bhagawan. And this month, entire month of Margashira, supposed to do that. And so all these customs we have, very beautiful. It's meant to break the tamas. Because given a chance, we will just settle down, you know. And and so, very, very interesting. And, you know, this thing is coming up January 14th. Pongal is coming up. So, Surya, Sankaramanam, Uttarayana is going to start. So, big, very big time in our country. So much, it's a big celebration. Because the sun is now... And the days are going to get longer starting from that time. And so we are thinking of chanting. There is something called Surya Namaskara Mantra in Vedas. So it's called Aruna Prashna. And so we are thinking of chanting. It will take 1 hour to chant. So we are planning to break this corona thing. We are going to plan to visit Swamiji's Kutia and then chant that. 6 in the morning. So we'll see how that works out. That used to be our tradition. We used to do that all the time. So therefore, following a discipline is not easy at all. Simply, it's easy to sit on the couch and then, you know, just just while away the time. And so here, those who follow my teaching, ye me matam anutishthanti, and because we know, we can't simply say it's hard to be disciplined. Hey, what is the difference between a human being and an animal? And we saw that ahara nidra bhaya maithunancha samanam etat pashubir naranam. Hey, there is all this fear and ahara, need for food, and then procreation. All these things are identical among all living beings. So what is unique about the human being? Dharmohi tesham. Buddhirhi tesham, that dharma, that buddhi, that alone makes me unique, makes the human being unique. And so we have to use that viveka. That buddhi helps me ask questions. What is all this about? And what should I do, really speaking? What is dharma? Why is dharma important? What is punyam papam? Can there be something called punyam and papam? Is it possible? And why is it important for me? All these questions only a human mind can ask. We are not living on instincts, based on instincts. Animals' life is based on instincts, purely instincts. But human life is not like that. And so here, so abhyasuyantaha, look at that. Same word, anasuyantaha in the previous shloka. Here, abhyasuyantaha. The an is not there, but the prefix here is abhi. Abhi asuyantaha. So asuyantaha means people who find fault in everything. Okay. Here in particular, the shastram. And shastram, finding fault in shastram has a basis in finding fault in everybody, right? And wife is not good, husband is not good, children are not good, this is not good, he is not good, she is not good. This is how it is. Only that mind can find fault. So asuyantaha. Abhi asuyantaha. Abhi means completely. This is constantly giving excuses. You know, Bhagavad Gita. So like I said just a few minutes ago. Karma yoga. You know, what is the use of all this karma yoga and all that? Doesn't make sense. There is nothing. Study Bhagavad Gita, you won't get anything. Or if that argument doesn't fly, then Gita is for Arjuna. Are you Arjuna? Tell me, are you a Kshatriya? You're not a Kshatriya. Arjuna had a problem, he had a conflict. What conflicts do you have? You don't have that kind of conflicts. It's not meant for you. Why are you studying the Bhagavad Gita? So like this, we can give all kinds of reasons. Arjuna, this teaching was done so many thousands of years ago. Can it be relevant now? Time is changing or not? Times are changing. They're changing very fast. And we are here in this iPhone world and WhatsApp world and Telegram world and Signal world. And people are deciding, even WhatsApp is now going to go away. Can you believe this? And that's how fast the world is moving. And you are telling Bhagavad Gita. It's all over. Those times are old. You have to look for some new stuff. Okay. So like this, very convincing arguments also. That is Treta Yuga. Now, don't you know we are all in Kali Yuga? And Kali Yuga, don't you know Bhagavad Gita won't work? So suddenly you get a doubt, you know. Serious student will get a doubt. Really? Kali Yuga, Gita won't work? Very convincing arguments they make. So, anyway. And what does Gita do to you anyway? And it only takes away your freedom. It says, all yajna, yajnarthat, karmanon, yatra, loko, yam karma, bandhanaha. Look at the whole world as Ishvara and then offer it to Bhagavan and all that. Come on, be free, enjoy life. You're too serious, my dear. I don't like it. I have to tell your parents, this is not good. And you know, you begin to doubt yourself, right? Some self-doubt is there sometimes. And so, yeah, I think I've become too serious with this Bhagavad Gita. And then begin to doubt. So, this is Anas. So, Abhi Asuyantaha. These fellows won't give up. Okay. Vedanta will not stand a chance against such people. Okay. So, that is called Abhi Asuyantaha. Krishna is referring to them. And Ye na anutishtanti me matam. And he's going to describe them by other words like sarva jnana vimudhan. Sarva jnana vimudhan. He's going to say that. So we will see what that means. And he's going to say, consider them to have been destroyed. Nashtan. Like that he's going to say. So let's see what that means in the next class. Om Swasti Prajabhyav Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahim Mahishaha Gobrahmanebhyah Shubhamastu Nityam Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu Kale Varshatu Parjanyaha Prithivi Sasya Shalini Desho Yam Kshobharahitaha Brahmana Santu Nirbhayaha Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha Sarve Santu Niramayaha Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu Ma Kaschit Dukkha Bhag Bhavet Asato Ma Sadgamaya Tamaso Ma Jyotirgamaya Mrityor Ma Amritangamaya Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om